Hey guys, my name is Lily and today I want to bring you the news from Austria, Germany and the center of Europe. It's now May 2023. In the past 6 to 7 weeks we had a really cold weather. It has been cloudy, cold, sometimes raining, but actually not enough of rain to fill up our water table. So the water table is still very low. But it was really cold, sometimes freezing temperatures, and I had a really hard time bringing my own tomatoes through in my greenhouse and polytunnels. So I had to heat my polytunnels with candles for 4 weeks. So it was really unusually cold this spring. So that was the weather, and now it seems to get nicer. And I'm looking forward for a nicer summer because my tomato plants are still a little bit too small. So by the time last year, they were much higher than this, and yeah, that really sucks. Anyway, I want to give you the news of this month or the last month. So what happened in Europe? I'm bringing the news from Austria and also Germany, and that's because I can speak German. So now I want to go through what's relevant. Relevant is of course the inflation, which is still persisting. So this article says that Germany has once been a very cheap country for food and water, but those times are now gone. Then the next article that you can see here is that in Germany, less and less people are buying food, and that's because it's so expensive. So here it's saying that this dip in consumption of food has become the strongest in the last 30 years. So only in 1994, they have bought less food than now. And that's really unimaginable. So they are already talking about that many shops will now close because they are not making enough of money anymore. And yeah, the demand of supermarkets is going back as well. Yeah, then unfortunately the inflation is rising again. So now we have 9.8% of inflation in Austria again. It doesn't seem to really come down. Actually, there are a few different consumer price indexes. One is even higher, it seems. So this is the graph, how the consumer prices are going up. Now they seem to stabilize. So it seems to be plateauing at 9.8% or around 10%. And the central bank here in Europe is trying to counteract the inflation with the rise of interest rates. But then, at the other hand, that's a problem for the young families who have just bought a house or flat and who have now a lot of debts. Then here's another article from Germany, and it's stating that a lot of companies are now leaving Germany because the rise of electricity prices and also the rise of natural gas is killing companies. Yeah, so a lot of companies are now leaving Germany and they go abroad, where they get a better price for electricity and natural gas. So what we see here is a deindustrialization of Germany and also of other countries here in Europe. And that's of course really sad, because if the company moves away, then also you will have a lot of people who are, you know, not finding a job anymore. Yeah, here the next article says that a lot of people in the middle class are afraid of their existence, and a lot of people in the middle class are now afraid that they will drop down into the lower middle class or even into the very low income class. So that's a big fear that people from the middle class have now. And actually what I'm seeing is that what's happening is that houses, single houses, are now getting sold to, you know, big building companies. And then they just destroy the houses and they build like 10 units on the same space. So now people, you know, they don't have a lot of garden anymore, just very tiny little ones. And that's happening more and more. So those big building tycoons, they have a lot of money and they can offer a single household owner a lot of money for the houses, much more than a family could pay. And then they get the house. They pay a little bit more, yes, but they make so much money after that, because If you are buying a small flat right now, it's costing like 400,000 euros. If it's having a little bit of a garden, okay? I've even seen some small flats going for 450,000 euros here in the city. It's crazy. That's the price of what a house would cost you 6 years ago. So it's really, really crazy how the price is increasing, and they charge the same money for a super small apartment with a little bit of a garden, and that's it. So now they take 10 people or 10 units, apartment units, put it on the same space that this one family had before. And yeah, I don't like it because I like having a garden. I'm from the countryside. I always had a lot of space as a kid. We had a veggie garden, which was huge. We had a chicken coop. We had an orchard with fruit trees. So now that's not possible anymore, and people cannot even be self-reliant, even if they wanted to, because they put them into small human cubes, you know? And I don't think that's good. Actually, I know some people who live in those small row houses, and they are not really happy. You can hear the third neighbor talking in the garden when you are standing in your garden, and I think there's no privacy in the garden. It's really, I don't like it. Gladly, I was lucky 5 years ago, I bought a house, and yes, I took up a lot of debts, but now this house has become so much more expensive. Now I would not be able to buy the same house. In the midst of my heart, I'm a hippie. I love all people. I want people to be happy. I want everybody to reach middle class, to have one or two cars, maybe a pool, maybe a garden where they can plant vegetables. And it's just reversing now. So I feel like you are paying more for less quality of living. I'm really sad about that. So people are really struggling. They don't have a lot of money. So the middle class in Austria was normal. Everybody, almost everybody, was a member of the middle class. There were only a few rich ones and only very few poor ones. But when I was a kid, everybody was middle class. I remember when I was growing up at the countryside, everybody was in the middle class. No matter what job you had, you were able to build your own house. Even if you worked, I don't know, at a supermarket, and maybe the husband worked as a builder or something. So it was always possible to acquire a house. So back then, when I was small, a lot of people built houses even with zero debts or very little debts, because the prices of property were cheap, the prices of material was cheap, and prices of labor were also cheap, especially at the countryside. So I know a lot of people, they've built houses without taking up a lot of debts, and a house back then would cost like 250,000 euros, and sometimes even less. You would get houses 10 years ago for 80,000 euros if you bought them at the countryside. But now all of that has changed. So yeah, it's really bad, and people are losing a lot. And if you don't have a house, flat, or some kind of property right now, then I don't see a chance how you can finance this anymore. And as I said before, that makes me really sad, because I'm in the depth of my heart somewhere, I'm a hippie, and I want everybody to prosper and to have a good life, you know, to be able to go into a restaurant once a week, or maybe to the cinemas or whatever. But it's completely going into the other direction. So now people are saving money wherever they can. It's not only luxury goods anymore, but also foods in the supermarket. If you have a greenhouse and you heat the greenhouse with natural gas, then you will have like 400% more costs of heating the greenhouse. So this is why a lot of prices has gone up when it comes to veggies. And now, gladly, we still have the south of Europe, which is really hot, and we get a lot of our vegetables from Spain, Italy, Greece, and so on. So gladly we have those countries that are still producing food like crazy for a very good price, and that's because they don't have these heating costs for their greenhouses. So here we got another article about a survey of the Caritas, which is a social organization that is helping people in need, and they are stating that Now, 1.5 million of Austrians are at the risk of poverty. And that's a lot, because we only have 9 million people. So if 9 million is 100%, then 1.5 million is 16%, 16.6 periodical. So 16% are already at the risk of poverty, which sucks. And yeah, that's bad for a country with a proper social welfare system. Now, the next thing that I've noticed is that our healthcare system is really struggling, and that's because a lot of doctors have left the hospitals, and also nurses, they have quit because they were burnt out after the pandemic, and now they don't have enough of doctors. So now what they're doing again is they have implemented the triage system. So if there are too many patients, they can only treat a certain amount, and if you unlucky, you don't get treated. So that's really bad. So yeah, as you can see, the entire economy of Austria and also in other countries in Europe is taking a huge hit. And also our healthcare system and our social welfare system is taking a hit. And we had the best doctors, we had the best hospitals in Austria, the best surgeries. We had almost no homelessness. We still don't have a lot of homeless, but we almost never had poor people. And if they were poor, they would get help. And now all of this is going down the drain. It's crazy. And this is how dangerous a recession is. People always underestimate a recession, but there are a lot of things that are going on in the background, which is making everyone's lives miserable, and people are suffering. They are really suffering. So, and all of this really makes me sad, because I believe that everybody should be able to reach middle class. But the conditions are just not here anymore. And even though maybe our father generation or my generation can still do it with taking up a lot of debts and working really, really hard, I think it's game over for our children and grandchildren, because they don't have the right conditions anymore to start with their lives properly. So yeah, I think now it's time to make smart decisions, save money where you got it, prepare for bad times. That's my only advice that I can give to you. I hope that you're preparing, because the world right now is not in a very good place. I hope it's going to change to the better, but who knows. Alright guys, so I have to stop this video now, because I'm burning up inside of this car. I'm going to get some more preps from this shop here. And also, if you want to see more news like this, then make sure that you're subscribing to my channel. And if you see something going on, make sure you leave me a comment below and let us know what you see. Thank you for watching, guys, and stay tuned till next time.